Hello, traders. Gary Wagner here, just about 10:30 in Honolulu, 3:30 in New York. It is Wednesday, the day that the Federal Reserve has announced the first increase in interest rates in almost a decade, raising at a quarter point, December 16, 2015. And this is the daily report for gold and silver. Although well off the highs, we do have gold trading higher this morning, currently trading up at around $9 on the day, $9 and change at 1070 and change. Now, it opened at 60. It's been pretty wild throughout the day. It had a high of 78 and a low of 1060. As I said, currently trading at around 1070, call it. First chart I do want to take a look at is a short-term chart, but I am definitely going to want to convert this chart into a standard candlestick chart. And the reason is that we'll get true open, low, high, and close. We'll probably even convert it a little bit more. And I draw your attention really to the point in which the Fed announcement came out, and that's this candle right here. You can see this is where we had a high of 1078. We had a low right in this particular candle of around 1061. And so we've had some extremely wild gyration throughout the day. In fact, if we take this down to a very, very short-term chart, you'll see that as this market came in, well, I'll have to assess, but you get this wild activity right around here. Here's the announcement at 9 o'clock, and you can see this is when the market really takes off and flies, both to the upside as well to the downside. But that's when we saw some real downside pressure. Market then comes back up and then trades lower on the day. As I said, very, very short-term chart. Now, interestingly enough, I expected that if we did get a rate hike, we would see that really boost the dollar. Now, the dollar had been trading negative. It's only up slightly, up 0.2%, currently at 98.43. The low of the day is 97.65 with a high of 98.55. So you can see that it has just started to move up. When we look at our chart, which has our euro dollar on the bottom and our dollar on the top, no doubt you can see that we are moving definitely in a positive territory. We've pegged support in this particular market at roughly 98, 97, 92, and that's this 38% retracement. When we look at the euro, you can see that the euro is coming right to where we consider support, which is about 108.9. We are currently at 108.97. So we're just at that point, and it's going to be interesting to see if we get the euro breaking a little bit harder vis-a-vis against the dollar. We certainly have some upside activity in the U.S. dollar. Crude oil under tremendous pressure today, just falling out of bed again, $35.63 a barrel, down $1.72 a barrel, more importantly, down about 4.5% on the day. You can see that on this weekly chart. This was just a tremendous 11-point drop when we look at what happened in the market last week. Let's go ahead and blow this up. And if we convert this weekly into a daily, you will get a better sense or a feel for what we're witnessing today. And that's after two days of a dead cat bounce, so to speak. And that's what I believe we're looking at. You're getting this return to lower pricing. So traders, we also saw silver rally pretty hard, although when we look at what's happened over the most recent activity, meaning the last couple of hours, we are well off of the highs of the day. Market's still up 37 cents at 14.13, so it's back above $14, high 32. So you can see we're, what, 20 cents off the high, the low 13.75, and you can really see that when you look at this daily chart. Let's go ahead and blow that up just a little bit, but you can see, 240-minute chart, not a daily chart, but on this 240-minute chart, you've got your day, which begins here. The market really spikes up, hits this top at around 14.32, and then we have seen it backing off ever since that point. So we are sitting with a short position. We are short at 78. Market is currently trading at 69. We took a little bit of heat this morning. Our stop's still at 88. As I said, I didn't really want to work with our stop today because my sense was we would have some pretty wild gyrations. We absolutely got the wild gyrations. And even though we're up $9 on the day, we are well off the highs. And my sense is that with the news that's out about the initiation of interest rate hikes, liftoff has begun, the long, long period, the 9-year period in which we saw no rate hikes has ended. So this is absolutely a historical day. We'll see how this all has to unfold. We did issue a buy signal right as the announcement came out in the Standard & Poor's E-mini. We got in roughly at 43, markets at 67 right now. So a tremendous move in the marketplace. We're way above what I consider to be any kind of level we had to break through, which was 43. And that's the point we actually took on the trade itself. Traders in that call continue to maintain your long position in the S&P and absolutely continue to maintain our short position in gold. This has been Gary Wagner wishing you, as always, good trading. We'll talk to you tomorrow on Thursday for another daily update and review. Bye-bye.